Hi everyone, I'm Antonio, a developer advocate here at Grafana Labs. Welcome to this tutorial. This is the first part of the Get Started with Grafana Alerting tutorials. In this walkthrough, I will show you how to create alert rules and set up notifications to stay on top of important events in your data. All right, before you begin, there are various ways you can follow along with this tutorial. I will use my own Grafana Cloud account, but if you do not have an account yet or prefer to run it yourself, you have two other options. The first option is to try out this example in our interactive learning environment where you have a fully configured Grafana instance. One last option is to run a Grafana stack locally. There are many platforms on which you can run Grafana, such as a downloaded binary, a package manager, Kubernetes, or Docker. If you opt for this option, you can find the steps to run it on Docker. Regardless of your choice, and once you have logged to Grafana, let's get started. The first step is to create a contact point, but before we do so, allow me to quickly explain what a contact point is and what you can do with it. Contact points are integrations that send notifications to specific destinations, such as email, webhooks, or services like Slack, PagerDuty, or Grafana OnCall. Besides the built-in integration options, we can also customize how the message will look like by using templates, or even configure Grafana to send alert notifications to certain contact points, by using notification policies, which we cover in a tutorial link below. Okay, let's create a contact point. We begin with this step before creating the alert rule, so that we have a contact point ready to link to the alert rule that we will create later. In Grafana sidebar, navigate to Alerts and IRM, then click Contact Points. Click Create Contact Point. In Name, write Webhook. In Integration, choose Webhook or any other integration of your choice. In another tab, go to webhook.site, where you will obtain a public webhook URL. This will allow us to test that the notifications are sent correctly. Copy the webhook URL and navigate back to Grafana. In URL, paste the endpoint. Click Test and then click Send Test Notification. Navigate back to webhook.site and you should see the test notification. Return to Grafana and click Save Contact Point. Great, we have our contact point. With our contact point ready, we can now move on to setting up an alert rule. But before we do that, allow me to quickly explain that in Grafana, you can create Grafana-managed and data source-managed alert rules. Grafana-managed alert rules can query data from multiple data sources in a single alert rule. They are flexible as you can add expressions to transform your data, set alert rule conditions, and add templates. That said, let's go ahead and create a Grafana managed alert rule. This alert rule will allow us to define when and how alert rules should trigger based on our data. We will use test data source, which is included in Grafana, to create random time series data to create an alert rule that always fires so we can see exactly how notifications are sent and received. Let's configure the alert rule. In Grafana, navigate to Alerts and IRM Alert Rules. Click on New Alert Rule, enter a name for the alert rule. Make it short and descriptive as this appears in your alert notifications. For instance, database matrix. Next, let's define the query and alert condition. In this section, we use the default options for Grafana Manage Alert Rule creation. Select the test data source from the drop-down menu. In the alert condition section, keep when query is above zero, which displays the last value of aggregated time series values, and zero as the threshold value. This is the value above which the alert rule should trigger. Click Preview Alert Rule Condition to run the query. It should return random time series data, and the alert rule state should be firing. Next, we add folders and labels. In Folder, click New Folder and enter a name. For example, Metric Alerts. This folder contains our alerts. Next, set the evaluation behavior. The alert rule evaluation defines the conditions under which an alert rule triggers. Click New Evaluation Group, name it 1 minute evaluation. Choose an evaluation interval. This is how often alert rules are evaluated. For example, every 1 minute. Set the pending period to 0 seconds. So the alert rule fires the moment the condition is met. keep firing for defines how long an alert should remain in the firing state after the alert condition stops being true. This is to avoid additional notifications when alerts quickly switch between firing and resolve due to noisy or unstable metrics. So we will set it to zero. Finally, in the configure notification section, choose the contact point where you want to receive your alert notifications. Under contact point, select webhook from the drop-down menu. Click save, rule, and exit. Now that our alert is configured, we are ready to see it in action. Grafana will automatically evaluate the alert rule based on the conditions we set. And once the rule fires, we will receive a notification. The alert notification details show that the alert rule state is firing, and it includes the value that made the rule trigger by exceeding the threshold of the alert rule condition. The notification also includes links to see the alert rule details and another link to add a silence to it. And this is how the exact same notification will look like if you instead use Slack or email as the contact point. And that's it for this tutorial. You have set up an alert rule and received notifications. In the next tutorial, I will show you how you can leverage the alert instances for routing. Just follow the link at the bottom of the tutorial, or if you're watching on YouTube, you can also find the link to that and the rest of the tutorials in the description. Thanks for following along, and see you in the next tutorial.